Hello students, today in this lecture we are going to do one numerical based upon these topics, that is the chronological load curve, load duration curve, mass curve, energy load curve, then load factor, capacity factor and utilization factor. Okay, a single numerical in which we have to draw all the four curves and to calculate these factors. Okay, so let's start with the numerical portion. Okay, so these are some of the definitions which we have covered in our last lecture. So load factor, it is the energy consumed during a time of t hours divided by the peak load into t. So t depends that whether we have to calculate the load factor yearly, monthly or daily. Okay, next, the reserve capacity is the installed capacity minus maximum demand. Then plant capacity factor, it is the average demand divided by the rated plant capacity, or generally we are going to use this formula. Capacity factor, that is the maximum load divided by the plant installed capacity multiplied by load factor. Okay, then there is utilization factor, which is equal to maximum demand divided by the rated plant capacity. And their interrelation is capacity factor, it is equal to the utilization factor into load factor. Okay, there is one more, that is the plant use factor, and this one is equal to actual energy produced divided by the installed capacity of the plant multiplied by the number of operating hours. Okay, that how much number of hours is the plant is in the running condition, or it is also calculated by using this formula, like average demand multiplied by T and divided by the installed capacity and the number of operating hours. Here T is 24 if we have to use the plant use factor for the daily purpose. But if we have to use this factor, calculate this factor for monthly purpose, then we have to use T as 24 into 30. Okay, so these are the all the factors. Now let's come to the numerical portion. So let's take this example. A generating station of 1 megawatt. So this 1 megawatt is its installed capacity. Okay, it is given installed capacity of 1 megawatt. Mega is 10^6. Supplied a region which has the following demands. That is, from midnight to 5 a.m. it is 100 kilowatt. 5 a.m. to 6 p.m. it is no load. 6 p.m. to 7 p.m. 800 kilowatt. 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. 900 kilowatt, and 9 p.m. to midnight again it is 400 kilowatt. Okay, and here we are neglecting the transmission losses, and we have to find draw firstly the daily load curve, then load duration curve, then calculate the load factor, reserve capacity, capacity factor, plant use factor, and the hours that the plant has been off and utilization factor. Okay, this all we have to calculate. So how to draw the daily load curve? Daily load curve, or you can also call it as the chronological load curve. Okay, you can also call it as chronological load curve. So just see the data, like from midnight to 5 a.m. it is 100 kilowatt. Okay, so from midnight, that is this, to 5 a.m. it is 100 kilowatt. Just mention on the y-axis there is the load in kilowatt. And on the x-axis, there is the time. Okay. Then from 5 a.m. to 6 p.m., there is no load. Okay. Here it is 6 p.m. There is no load. And 6 p.m. to 7 p.m., 800. 7 p.m. to 9 p.m., it is 900. Just check it. Like from 5 to 6 p.m., 6 is represented by 18. And that is here the load is 800 kilowatt. Then 7 to 9, it comes out to be 900 kilowatt. Okay, then from 9 to midnight, it is 400 kilowatt. Then it is again decreasing and 400 kilowatt. So in this way, you have to draw the chronological load curve. Okay, so this one is simply called the load curve or chronological load curve. And from this curve, now we have to draw the load duration curve. So what is the definition for the load duration curve? That it is the rearrangement of loads in the decreasing order. Okay. firstly, the highest load is plotted first. Okay, then the next lowest, then next lowest, then next lowest, and so on. Okay, so what is the highest load here? It is 900 kilowatt, and it remains for, just check it from this table, how many hours? It remains for 2 hours. Okay, from 7 to 9. So for 2 hours, the load is 900. Then 800 just for 1 hour. Okay, then next lowest is 400 for, just check from this table for how many hours? It is from 9 p.m. to 12. That is for the 3 hours. Okay, so iske aage next 3 hours, there are 400. And then next 100. And then to this duration of time, na, there is no load. Nil. Okay, so this is how to draw the load duration curve. That means it is the rearrangement of loads in the decreasing order. Is the rearrangement of loads in the decreasing order. Now we have to calculate the load factor, and for that firstly calculate the average load. So average load is area under the load curve. So area under the load curve, we know that it represents energy, okay, divided by the number of hours. So how to calculate the area under the load curve? So here it is, number of hours are 5 multiplied by 100, 5 multiplied by 100, plus from this point to this point, there is no load. Okay, so it is 13 multiplied by 0 plus, now this portion, 800 multiplied by 1, 900 multiplied by 2, and 400 multiplied by 3. Just sum up all the load, whether you take this criteria from this curve or directly from the table. Okay? Like 100 multiplied by 5, 13 multiplied by no load, okay, then 800 multiplied by 1, then 900 multiplied by 2, then 400 multiplied by 3, and so on, okay, and divided by 24, because we are calculating here the daily load curve, okay, so this comes out to be 179.16 kilowatt. So this comes out our average load. Now applying the formula for the load factor. So it is average load divided by maximum load. Average load is just this one, 179.16, divided by maximum load is 900. Okay, the peak load, it is 900. So just divide and it gives you 0.199. And just one thing to note down here, that the load factor is always generally less than 1. Okay, and in percentage you can write this answer as 19.19%. okay, and how to calculate the reserve capacity? The formula is installed capacity minus maximum demand. So what is the installed capacity in kilowatts, because the maximum demand is given in kilowatts. So installed capacity in the question, it is given that 1 megawatt, or you can call it as 1000 kilowatt. Okay, so just applying the formula, 1000 minus 900, 900 is the maximum demand. So the reserve capacity comes out to be 100 kilowatt. Okay, now next is the plant capacity factor. So here we are going to apply this formula, that is average demand divided by the installed capacity. The average demand is 179.16 divided by installed is 1000 kilowatt. Okay, and it comes out to be 0.1791. Okay, so this is the capacity factor. Next is the plant use factor. The formula is actual energy produced in kilowatt hour divided by the plant capacity into the number of hours. Now, that means how many hours the plant is in use. Okay, so energy produced is just we have calculated here. So this one is the energy produced, that is 4300 kilowatt hour. Okay, divided by capacity is 1000 kilowatt, and the number of hours the plant is in the working condition, that is 11 hours. Okay, because these 13 hours the plant load on the plant is nil. No load is there on the plant. So we are omitting these hours and left with only 11 hours. Okay, so the plant use factor comes out to be 0.3909 or you can say 39.09%. Okay. Now the next is the utilization factor. The formula for this is maximum demand divided by the installed capacity. And maximum demand, we know that it is 900. Installed capacity is 1000 kilowatts. So utilization factor comes out to be 0.9 or 90%. Okay, so in this way, you can simply draw the curves and calculate the various factors. Okay, now this is the next example which we have to do on the board. And for this data, like the data, the load on power plant on any day is as under: from 12 to 5, it is 20. From 5 to 9, it is 35. From 9 a.m. to 6 p.m., it is 85. Okay, 85 megawatt. Megawatt load hai. From 6 to 10 p.m., it is 105 megawatt. And from 10 p.m. to 12 a.m., it is 30 megawatt. Okay. And for this data, you have to plot the chronological load curve, then load duration curve, then mass curve, and energy load curve, and also calculate the energy consumed, load factor, utilization factor, and capacity factor. And the installed capacity of the plant given is, it is 125 megawatt. So this capacity is given. So this much data is given in the question, and you have to calculate all this. Okay, so let's start this numerical on the board now. Okay, let's do the same numerical on the board. And the data that is given in the question, that is from 12 to 5 a.m. it is 20 megawatt load. 5 to 9 a.m. it is 35 megawatt load. From 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. it is 85 megawatt. 6 to 10 p.m. it is 105 megawatt. And from 10 p.m. to 12 a.m. it is 30 megawatt. Okay, and the installed capacity given is 125 megawatt. So firstly, we have to draw the chronological load curve and then the load duration curve. Okay, then we have to perform some calculations and the remaining curve, energy curve and mass curve after that. Okay, so for the chronological load curve, firstly, we have to draw the chronological load curve. Okay, so for the chronological load curve, you have to draw the graph like this. Just I am going to draw it like this. And as my load varies from 20 to 105, so I am taking here the margins as 20, 40, 60, 80, 100 and 120. So I am taking the margins of 20 megawatt, and here on this side there is the load in megawatts. Okay, this is the load in megawatt, and on the x-axis I am taking the time format as it is given in the question. So as 12, I'm just taking here as 12, 6, again 12, here it is again 6 and again 12. Okay, so this one is the AM and here it is PM. Okay, or you can just mention it as time in hours. Okay, so the first step is to mention or properly mentioning it on the x-axis or y-axis. Inko achhe se mention kar dena ki what is there on the y-axis and what is there on the x-axis. Now let's start with the chronological load curve. Like from 12 to 5 a.m. it is 20 megawatt load. So 5 is somewhere here and the load is 20. Okay, so this is my curve. And next from 5 to 9 a.m. it is 35 megawatt. So 9 is somewhere here. Here I am just mentioning here 5 and here it is 9. So 5 to 9 a.m. it is 35 megawatt and 35 megawatt is somewhere here. Just like this. Okay. Then from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. it is 85 megawatts. 6 p.m. here it is. Okay. Just draw the dotted line. And it is 85 megawatt. 85 megawatt is somewhere here. And you can draw like this. Okay, so this is the curve. And next from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. it is 105. So 10 is almost, here it is 9 and here it is approximately 10. And the load is 105. So 105 comes out to be somewhere here. And like this. Okay. And next one is from 10 p.m. to 12 a.m. It is 30. So 30 is approximately here. Just draw the dotted lines in between. And so this is my chronological load. Okay. This is how to draw the chronological load curve. Simply you have to mention the loads and just make. Yes, now for the load duration. From the load duration curve, that it is the rearrangement of loads of the chronological load curve in the decreasing order. ठीक है, इन्हीं loads को decreasing order में rearrange कर देना है in the load duration curve. So here in the load duration curve, like this, just mention the margin for load on the y-axis. I'm taking the same margins, 20 40 60 80 100 and 120. Okay, here it is load in megawatt. Okay, ye properly हर एक्सिस पे, एक्स एक्सिस, वाई एक्सिस, सब पे लिखना है, अदरवाइज इसी की मार्क्स कटिंग हो जाती है. ओके, एंड ऑन द एक्स एक्सिस नाउ वी आर सिलेक्टिंग द टाइम स्लॉट एज 0 to 24 स्लॉट. ओके, सो जस्ट मेंशन हियर एज 0, लाइक 4, 8, 12, 16, 20 and 24. ओके, for the load duration curve, because it is drawn in the decreasing order, na, so you have to take the margins for timing like this. Okay, so here it is the time in hours on the x-axis. So now what is the highest maximum load? That is 105. Okay, it is given in the table, it is 105 and it remains for 4 hours. Okay, so 4 hours the load is 105. So like this you have to plot. The load is 105. Just write it here as 105 for the 4 hours. Okay, and next lowest is 85. Now directly come to the 85. Here it is 85 and it remains from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Okay, it remains for 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. So how many number of hours are there? It is for the 9 hours. So what is 4 plus 9? It comes out to be 13. Okay. This 85 megawatt load remains for 9 hours. And you have to add that 9 hours from this 4. Okay, so here it is 85 megawatt. Okay, and it remains for 9 hours, and 4 plus 9 gives you 13. Here it is 13 now. Okay, next lowest is 35. So 35 remains for 5 a.m. to 9 a.m. that is for the 4 hours. Okay, so come to the point of 35 first. So So here, and 35 megawatt load remains in the system for the 4 hours. So 13 plus 4 gives you 17. And like this, here it is 17. So here the load is 35. Okay, now the next lowest is 30. So 30 megawatt load remains in the system for 2 hours. And come to the 30, it remains for 2 hours. 17 plus 2, it is 19. So here it is 19. And the load is 30. Okay, the next lowest load is 20, and it remains in the system for from 12 to 5 a.m. That is for the 5 hours. And what is 19 plus 5? It is 24. So one thing to just note down that in this load duration curve, your 24 hours must be completed. Wo complete hone chahiye. Theek hai? So the next is the 20. Here it is number 20, and the load is remains for the 5 hours. So in this way, you have to draw the load duration curve. And for the load duration curve, your whole 24 hours should be completed. And loads are arranged in the decreasing order. First, the highest load, that is 105. Then next, 85. Then next, 35. Then 30. And then 20. Okay. Just write it down here also that 105 is for the 4 hours. 85 remains for 9 hours. 35 remains for 4 hours and 30 remains for 2 hours and 20 remains for again 5 hours. And the sum of all these hours must be 24. Just to check out your correctness. Okay. So this is how to draw the load duration curve. Now the next step is to calculate the energy. Next step is to calculate energy. So we know that energy is power into time. Okay. So just see from the table, this is our power, this is our time. Just multiply and add them to calculate the energy. So firstly, the power is 20 and it remains for 5 hours. So 20 multiplied by 5 plus next is 35. 35 multiplied by from 5 to 9, it is 4. Like this. Okay. Plus, next is 85 from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. The total number of hours comes out to be 9. So, it is 85 multiplied by 9. Okay. Plus, 105 multiplied by 6 to 10, it is 4 hours plus 30 multiplied by 50. So just do this calculation and this will give you the energy. Yes, do this calculation. So the energy comes out to be 1485. It is in the megawatt hours. Okay. So after calculating this energy, the next step is to calculate the load factor, then capacity factor, and then utilization factor. Okay. So next is the to calculate the load factor. So the formula for the load factor here we are going to apply is the energy divided by the maximum load into the time. Okay, this formula we are going to use here. So the load factor, it is energy. Energy comes out to be 1485 divided by the maximum load. Maximum load is 105 multiplied by the time, and the number of hours are 24. So this is the load factor that we have to calculate. Next is the capacity factor. Just do the calculations. Next is the capacity factor, and here we are going to apply the, that is the maximum demand divided by installed capacity into load factor. Okay, that means maximum demand divided by installed capacity multiplied by load factor. Okay, this is our capacity factor. So maximum demand here it is 105 divided by installed capacity, it is given in the question, that is 125, and the load factor which you have to calculate from here. Okay, so and next one is the utilization factor. Utilization factor. So it is the maximum demand divided by capacity, installed capacity. Okay, installed capacity. Okay, and the maximum demand is 105 divided by 125. Okay, so do all the calculations. So the answer for the load factor comes out to be 0.589. For capacity factor, it comes out to be 0.49. And for utilization factor, it comes out to be 0.84. Now let's start with the energy load curve first. So for the energy load curve, firstly, we have to do some calculation part, like, as we know that the for the energy load curve, it is drawn between the energy and load. Okay, the load is taken on the y-axis and the energy is plotted on the x-axis. Okay, so but before plotting the actual curve, we have to do some calculations, like, yes, for energy load curve. As it is plotted between load and energy, so we have to calculate the energy for each load first. Okay, and one thing is this, the calculations done for the energy load curve is to be done with the help of this load duration curve. Isko dekh dekh ke iski hum calculations karenge. Theek hai? So, matlab this, you have to take the help from this load duration curve. यहां से ये पहले ड्रॉ करेंगे, देन ओनली वी एबल टू डू द कैलकुलेशंस. लाइक स्टार्टिंग विद, फॉर द लोएस्ट लोड इज 20. ओके, फॉर 20 मेगावाट, फॉर 20 मेगावाट एनर्जी इज इक्वल टू, फॉर 20 मेगावाट एनर्जी इज इक्वल टू, लाइक दिस इज द लोड ऑफ 20 मेगावाट. Okay, just you have to see the load duration curve. This is the load of 20 megawatt, and this lowest 20 megawatt load is available for the whole 24 hours. Okay, if you see the area under this load duration curve, na, the 20 megawatt load is available for the complete 24 hours, as it is seen from this load duration curve. Okay, so for 20 megawatt the energy comes out to be, energy is simply power multiplied by time, so it is 20 multiplied by 24. Okay, and this comes out to be 480 megawatt. Just mention the units with each calculation. Okay, this comes out to be 480 megawatt. Okay, now next, the next highest load is 30 megawatt. Okay, now for 30 megawatt energy is equals to, and now see from again from this load duration curve that this 30 megawatt load, just draw the margin first. It is somewhere here. Okay, and I'm just marking here the lines. Okay. Now check from this load duration curve that for how many hours this 30 megawatt load is on, is switched on. Like you see there here that 30 megawatt load is switched for the 19 hours. See here, it is 19. Okay, so 19 hours ke liye ye load available hai. Now for here, you have to add the previous load. Because this 30 megawatt load also include this 20 also. Okay, just add this 480 plus next one is you have to add the area of this shaded portion. Okay, for this shaded portion, here it is 19 and here this margin is 10. Okay, this margin, that is from 20 to 30, the margin is 10. And here on the x-axis, the margin is 19. So here you have to write like 10 multiplied by 19. Like this. Okay. And just do the calculation like 480 plus 10 into 19, 190. And this will give you 670 megawatt hour. Okay, like this you have to do the calculation for the energy load curve. Now the next load, highest load is 35 megawatt. Now for 35 megawatt, energy is equal to, firstly you have to add the previous calculated load, that is 670 plus, now the next margin. This one is 35 megawatt. Okay, and it remains for the 17 hours. Just see here, it is for the 17 hours. And this is the margin now. Okay. You have to add this much area to this calculation. Okay, and on the x-axis, it is 17. And on the y-axis, this margin is from 30 to 35, it is 5 megawatt. Okay, clear? So here it comes out to be 5 multiplied by, here it is 17. Okay, and just do the calculations, that is 670 plus 17 multiplied by 5, it is 85, and finally the answer comes out to be 755 megawatt hour, like this. Okay, now the next highest load is 85. Now for 85 megawatt, energy is equal to, firstly add the previous calculated result, that is 755 plus, now see from the load duration curve that 85 is available for 13 hours. Okay, and now here you have to add this area, this much area, this one. Okay, this area you have to add, and for this area on the x-axis it is 13 and on the y-axis you have to take this margin from 35 to 85. Okay? 35 to 85. What is the difference between 35 to 85? Okay. So it comes out to be 50. Okay, so here you have to write like 50 multiplied by, here it is 13, like this. Okay, these 13 are the number of hours on the x-axis, and this 50 is the margin between 35 to 85. Okay, just do the calculations. So it is 755 plus 650. Okay, and it will gives you 1405 megawatt hour. Okay, and now the last slot, that is 105 megawatt. Now for 105 megawatt energy, it is equal to 1405 plus, yes, now see from this flow duration curve, 105 remains for the 4 hours. Okay, so you have to now add which area? This much area you have to add, this one, the topmost. Okay, and here on the x-axis it is 4, and on the y-axis, what is the margin between 85 and 105? It is 20. Okay, so this, here write down 20 multiplied by 4. Okay, just do the calculation. That is 1405 multiplied by, it is 80. And this will give you 1485 megawatt hour. And how to check these results? That the final answer must be same as your energy calculated previously. ठीक है, इसमें जो फाइनल आंसर निकलेगा ये इतना ही आना चाहिए जितना तुमने पहले एनर्जी निकाली है. ओके, सो द फाइनल आंसर, इफ योर फाइनल आंसर बी सेम एज योर प्रीवियसली कैलकुलेटेड एनर्जी, देन दैट मींस ऑल दीज कैलकुलेशंस आर करेक्ट. ओके, नाउ यू हैव टू प्लॉट और ड्रॉ द एनर्जी. ओके, आफ्टर दीज कैलकुलेशंस यू हैव टू ड्रॉ द एनर्जी लोड कर्व. नाउ okay, now for the energy load curve, on the y-axis there is load, and the load, these are the margins, by taking the same margins 20, 40, 60, 80, 100 and 105. Okay, here it is the load in megawatt. Okay, on the y-axis, just mention the energy in megawatt hour. Okay, and just see here, the maximum energy comes out to be 1485. So set the margins accordingly. I'm just writing here the margins as 300, then 600, then 900, then 1200, then 1500. I'm taking these margins, or you can take any margins. Okay, now for 20 megawatt energy is 480. Okay, starting from here, for 20 megawatt energy is 480. Like for 20, the energy is 480, it is somewhat here, and this one is for 20, and you just have to make point. Okay, just you have to mark one point. And next, for 30 megawatt energy, 670. So 670 is somewhat here. Here it is 30. This is my second point. For 35 megawatt energy, 755. Here it is somewhat 35. And 755 is approximately here. Like this, you just have to mark the points. And next, for 85 megawatt, It is 1405. 85 is somewhere here. And energy is 1405. So 1405 is somewhere here. Okay, so this is my next pointer. And for 105 megawatt load, the energy is finally 1485 megawatt hour. So this one is 105 and here is approximately 1485, and this is my the final point. And just join the points now like this. So this is our energy load curve. Okay, so this is finally the how to draw the energy load curve. Yes, now for the mass curve. As the mass curve is plotted between energy and time, so the calculations done for the mass curve, that we have to see this table that is given in the question. Okay, so let's start with the mass curve now. Mass curve calculations first. Like, as you have seen from this table, that the first interval of the time is 5 a.m. Okay, the next interval is 9 a.m. So you have to write down like this: energy supplied up to 5 a.m. Okay, energy supplied up to 5 a.m. The energy is same, power multiplied by time. So it is equal to 20 multiplied by 5. Okay, this gives you 100 megawatt hour. Okay, similarly, energy supplied up to 9 a.m. Next slot is 9 a.m. So in this you have to add the previously calculated energy, but then the total energy supplied up to 9 a.m. So it comes out to be this much, 100 plus the next slot. Okay, 100 plus 35 multiplied by 4, like this. Okay, that this will gives you the total energy supplied up to 9 a.m. Okay, and here it gives you 100 plus 140, and this will gives you 240 megawatt hour. Okay, and next slot is 6 p.m. Energy supplied up to 6 p.m. So again, add the previously calculated, that is 240 plus next load is 85. And for how many hours it is on? It is from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. like for the 9 hours. Okay, like this. So you have to add the previous next slot in the previously calculated results. So this will give you 240 plus 765. And finally, the answer comes out to be 1005 megawatt hour. Okay. Now, the next plot is up to 10 p.m. Energy supplied up to 10 p.m. So, here it is 1005 plus 105. Multiplied by how many hours are there? 4 hours are there. That is from 6 to 10 p.m. Okay, so here comes out to be 1005 plus 420. And finally, the answer comes out to be 1425 megawatt hour. Okay, now next the final slot, energy supplied up to 12 p.m. Yeah, 12 midnight. Okay, and here it is 1425 plus 30 multiplied by 2. Okay, and this will gives you 1425 plus 32s are, it is 60, and here finally the answer comes out to be 1485. Okay, and here it comes again the same energy that we have calculated earlier. Okay, so from this result that we satisfied that our answer is correct because it comes out to be the same answer. Now you have to plot the mass curve, and for the mass curve, just on the x-axis there is the time slot, like here it is 12. Just mention here the same slots, 5 a.m. then 9 a.m. okay, then 6 p.m. okay, then 10 p.m. and then 12. Okay, and here it is on the y-axis there be energy. We are taking the same margin as 300, 600, 900, 1200 and 1500, and this is energy. Just mention the axis first in megawatt hour. Okay, this is time in hours, like this. Okay, mention the axis properly. Okay, now for up to 5 a.m. it is 100. Up to 5 a.m. to 100 is somewhat here. In this, you again have to mark the points. Okay. Then for 9 a.m. it is 240. 240 is approximately here. And for 9, this is next pointer. And for 6 p.m. it is 1005. For 6 p.m. it is 1005 approximately here. Like this. And for 10 p.m. is 1425 approximately here. And finally for 12 it is 1485. So these are the points and you just have to join them like this. Okay, this is how to plot the mass curve. So in this way, in the single numerical, you have to plot all the curves like chronological load curve, load duration curve, energy load curve, and the mass curve. Okay, and you have to do all the calculations like energy firstly, then the load factor, then capacity factor, then utilization factor, or sometimes they've also called to calculate the reserve capacity or plant use factor also. Okay, so this is all about the loads, that is the numerical related to the loads and load curves. Okay, thank you. So this is a numerical which we done recently, and the next is this one. The effect of voltage on the loads, that how the different types of loads are affected by the voltage and how they vary with the voltage. Okay, the first is the lightning load. So the lightning loads do not consume any reactive power. Okay, then heating, the resistance is almost constant for the heating type loads, and the its active power varies as voltage here in general. And then the induction motor load, the performance of an induction motor can be analyzed from its equivalent circuit. The active and reactive power vary with voltage in a rather complex manner. Okay, then the synchronous motor load, the active power does not depend on voltage and remains more or less constant. Okay. The reduction in voltage causes the increase in the leading direction. And next is the effect of frequency on load. Okay, the power consumed by the resistive load does not depend on frequency. We know that the resistive loads are independent of frequency, whereas the inductive loads and capacitive loads depend upon the frequency. However, the most of the load in our houses are inductive in nature. So the impedance of an inductive load depends on frequency, as it is directly proportional to the frequency. Therefore, the power drawn by an inductive load depends on the frequency. So it is generally assumed that a 1% decrease in frequency causes a 1% decrease in active power. And the next topic is the load forecasting. So what is load forecasting? It is a technique used by power or energy providing companies to predict the power or energy needed to meet the demand and supply equilibrium. Okay, that means the energy is forecasted in that what is required in the future is forecasted first, and accordingly the demand of the existing power stations are increased or some new power plants are required to be installed. So what is the need of load forecasting? To determine the capacity of the generating transmission and distribution required, and to determine the type of generation facilities required, or for deciding purchasing of electric power, load switching and infrastructure development, or for scheduling fuel supplies and unit maintenance, or to determine the size and location of the plant. Next is to minimize the power outages and overloading. So these are the some of the requirements or necessity for the load forecasting, that why it is to be done. Okay. Next, the types of load forecasting. It's generally of two types, long term and short term. Okay, long term load forecasting takes a pretty long time to plan, install and commission additional generating capacity, and the generation system expansion and planning starts with the forecast of anticipated future and load requirements. Okay, that in advance the forecasting is done for the installation purpose of new generating stations. Next, the short-term load forecasting. It precise the short-term forecast is essential for the monitoring and controlling of the power system operation, which is in the generally in the daily purpose. The hourly load forecast with lead time up to 1 week in advance is necessary for online solution of the scheduling problems. So the load forecasting is of two types, long term and short term load forecasting. So this is all in this chapter.
Ma'am?
Loads and load curves.